So grandfather has four children, as far as I know, with this grandma, and so she's got two sons and two daughters. So that is like obaku, pebaku, tiamlaiku. You know, ku means to me like it's cool because it's my mom's brother, and
Right.
then two sisters, two girls, right? So obaku is the one who is an accountant, ingenious, westernized. So he set off, sailed off to Australia to study accountancy, got his chartered accountancy, worked with the United Nations, blah, blah, blah. So he stays in Singapore. But the Tiam Lai Aku, he's the one who is more business-minded, so he stays with his dad. And he is the one, I mean, like, dad probably, his dad passed a lot of things to him, but I think he deserved it because he really works hard, do the hard yan with the dad, carry goods and all those things, you know. So he inherited, I believe, a lot of, you know, that his dad's things are. But still, my grandfather, I think he was quite, and then Pak Baku, I don't know where he comes from, but he's part of the family. So they call him Pak Baku because he's like, he looks a bit like not Aussies, like Amor, you know, so they call him Pak Baku because he's very fat, fat, you see, Pak Baku. So that's with like Trick Aku, you know, yeah. So the house in Beach Street is actually, as I can remember, mom, I can recall, mom was telling the story of how when grandpa passed away, he told, I think it belongs to the Tiam Lai Aku and the Pak Baku because, no, Obaku, he is the first son of the family. So whether he's westernized, he's involved in the business or not. You know, I think in their China term, this is my first son. He still gets his things, you know. Yeah. So I think that house was left for both the sons, you know, but on the proviso that mom stays in there. My mom stays in there, you know. So that's how we all stays in there. So that's what my understanding is, you know. So
At that time, how many families were in that beach house?
we stay there. I think Tiam Lai Ku also stays, but she stays at the back part, the back portion, and then we stay at the front portion. And then downstairs, he conducts his business, and the back portion of the house, they rented it out for a transport company that runs the business. And then I think the workers' family stays in there as well. Yeah. So
Okay.
there's like one, two, three family.
So now that your family has really moved out, so I'm
No, I don't know who lives there anymore, nor do I know who owns it anymore. But when I left, it was all rented out already. So it's all the family. There was the transport company at the back, they're still running it. And then upstairs is their company's family staying. I think the front, I do not know because the last time I went back there was to clear my mom's things. That was many years ago, and that was it. And then Aku was still transacting business there, but Aku has already passed away as well, so I don't really know who owns those place now. Yeah, I have no idea who owns it. Yeah,